In this video, we will show you how to design a responsive side menu in WeWeb. For navigation menus, whether it's a top navigation menu like we saw in the Build an MVP course, or if it's a side menu like we are seeing here, or if it's a navbar at the bottom, we recommend starting with ready-made elements in WeWeb. The reason for that is that it will make your life much easier to handle responsive because we've done most of the hard work for you. In WeWeb, on our My Tickets page, we will go ahead and look for a layout that looks like our design. So in this case, it's the side menu. And see, we also have the navbar option, the bottom bar option, and other specific layouts like columns or alerts and side pop-up sidebars and modals. So in this case, we want the side menu. Let's drag and drop it. We will include the variables because this will help us with responsive. So if we place this on the page, if we go into preview mode, to the tablet, right away, if I click here, you see this is responsive, the menu is responsive, and same on mobile. This is because if we go back to editing mode and we look at this mobile header menu, the icon here has a workflow. And when the user clicks on that icon, we change the isOpen variable, which comes with the side menu component. We change it to the opposite of its current value. Another way of writing this would be to say not. And on the side menu itself, we have a workflow that says it's not open, it's false. So all of this is built in to the side menu section that you can find in the WeWeb toolkit. So this is why we recommend starting with an inbuilt WeWeb layout. Now, in my design, I also have a heading and kind of a main content. Back in WeWeb, I'm going to go back to my add menu and get the header and content from the side menu. Header and content. Why am I doing this? Well, my side menu, if I go on the menu container, I can see that the width is bound to a menuWidth variable that comes with the side menu. It's right here. So by default, it will be 280 pixels. And then if I go to my header section, I will see a margin of 280 pixels. And if I go to my content, I will see a margin of 280 pixels. That is why this looks nice. That said, you could take advantage of this menuWidth variable that comes with the side menu. You could change it to 300, for example. Let's save this. And then here's a little overlap. So on the header section, what you would want to do then is make this margin dynamic. So instead of a fixed 280 pixels width, you would want to bind it to the value that CSS expects. So in the case of margins, the value that CSS expects is something that looks like this. So let's try 10 pixels, 12 pixels, 13 pixels, and 15 pixels. So it needs a string. And what this is saying is it's saying the top margin is 10 pixels, the right margin is 12 pixels, the bottom margin is 13 pixels, and the left margin is 15 pixels. So it goes clockwise starting at the top. We can make this dynamic by saying, well, at the top, we don't want any margins. On the right, we don't want any margins. And the bottom, we don't want any margins. And the left margin, we want to bind to our menu width. And oops, we need a space here. And we need to say pixel. So when you're defining 0 pixels, it's best to not write the px for performance reasons, but you need to add the px after 300 to tell the browser it's pixels. And now you see there's no longer an overlap between the sidebar and the header section. You could copy this formula and paste it here, or you could create a reusable formula and say dynamic margin, content margins. And paste it here. And then you could bind to the formula here. So that way, if at some point you want to update this formula, you only have to update it here and it will automatically affect the header and the content here. Finally, on this page, to match our design here, we will make this container, the content container, 100%, and here the header we will align to the left so it looks a little bit nicer. That's it. That's how you build a responsive side menu in WeWeb that plays well with the main content of your page.